Hey, what's good, one?
Hey, what's good, one? How you been?
So, we're back. Another weekend. Another The Warning at the Pepsi Center reaction.
Should be good?
I'm excited for this. There's definitely going to be a couple songs that I'm looking forward to today. Definitely still looking at the ones you guys suggest. Today we're doing Choke, The Kool Aid Kids, and 23. Should be fire. I'm really impressed that they did all these songs in one concert, because that's a long concert and that's a lot of work. So big props. But yeah, we're gonna slowly get through the Pepsi Center concert. If there's other groups you guys want me to check out, I know a lot of you guys are new, let me know in the comment section. I don't want to make every video from on the channel about The Warning, so I definitely want to mix things up, throw in some other groups. Any suggestions you got would be awesome. Just let me know in the comment section and I'll check some stuff out. But we're here for The Warning. So let's do this. Take a seat. Grab a little drink. See, it'll be fine. So we're starting with Choke. I actually really like this song. It's definitely in the gym playlist. Definitely a solid song. I did listen to the music video first, so I wanted to give it a little space in between before we jumped back into it. But I liked it. It's really good. The lyrics are solid. Let's do this. Crowd is wild. She doesn't even need to sing. Crazy. Okay. The line is so strong. The pre-chorus into the chorus is so good. So good. Pre-chorus. I think definitely the pre-chorus like does it for me. Crazy. Like, I know what to expect, but it's still really good. To an extent, I know what to expect. Minor detail, but them appearing on all three screens in the back, decent touch. That high note is also kind of crazy. Ooh. Ali singing this part is a nice touch. Solid. No, this is live is different vibe for sure. I do remember you guys telling me to pause whenever I'm trying to say a long point. But this song is just really hard to find a good pausing point. Their tone, their vocal tone is really nice. The range is cool. It's like they sound good. Their tone can be really deep. So like, especially Ali's part, that was super, super dope. The song just hits different. I hate saying that term because it's overused a little bit, but it's between the pre-chorus, the chorus, and just it sounds very grand and epic while still being about like being in pain. What's the line? Wear your tears like jewelry. That vice is overpriced, but art is dead, it died with me. Heavy, heavy, heavy. I like it though. I think so far, this is my favorite The Warning song. So
the next song is 23. I am just gonna look at lyrics real quick. Can't you see that I want you so badly I can barely breathe? Killing me slowly. Okay, got you. So it's like a one-sided love that's toxic. Interesting. 23. Why 23? Or maybe it's because of the year? What year just come out? No. Okay.
Okay, so concept that I'm getting. It's like a kind of toxic one-sided love. And even though they're not good for them, they want them to stay in a way. All right, let's do this. Okay, so concept that I'm getting. It's like a kind of toxic one-sided love. And even though they're not good for them, they want them to stay in a way. All right, let's do this.
Feels like a more toned down part of the concert, maybe. But most of the songs have picked up, so. I looked at you same as before. What had changed, I do not know. But the thought of you were played in secret. It hurt me more than I asked for more. Falling down your rabbit hole. I kept on biting back what I was feeling.
That was crazy. That opener was crazy. Okay, okay.
And she continues.
Crazy. Someone did point this out to me. The fact that plays the drums and sings at the same time is crazy. Oh, okay. And she's main vocal. Someone told me in the comments. So, that's crazy. I really like the story they're putting here. Crazy. The arrangement on this one is crazy. I want this bridge. This bridge is gonna be wild.
Ooh. voice is really pretty. Circled bag. And the slowdown. Okay, I like the I like the back and forth they had in that ending. No, it was solid, because they circle back. I like the moment when they circle back to how they sung in the beginning. Super nice. I was told that she would have her own, Pao would have her own solo, but I didn't expect that. That was really good. Her voice is really pretty, and it's unexpected that she would sing that way. You know why? I don't know. I didn't expect her to sing differently, but her voice is really pretty and stands out differently from Danny's. It could have been the song. We're only four songs deep, but it was different, and I liked it. I really liked the fact that she sung most, if not all, of 23. And like I was saying before, the song itself dictates a little story, and it's not just a abstract thing. There was like a story. It's like, here, we're doing this, and this, and then the 23 line, "Can't seem to let you go," like, solid. This was solid. Okay, last one today is going to be Kool Aid Kids. That's either going to be something nostalgic or dark. "Hey, you Kool Aid Kids, there's a traitor in our midst." Something dark. Okay, did a little digging around. It is referencing Jonestown, the massacre that happened, which is why it's Kool Aid. And it's trying to push this idea of individual thinking, because it's dangerous if you don't, which is always good to push, but also kind of gives you a sort of secondary meaning, but it's like, it's in pre-chorus. It's sad to admit it's true that we find it way too easy to be too easy to be cruel. So it's like people are mean and violent first and too quickly. So okay, I dig it. That's a thin stage. Interesting. I didn't expect that long instrumental section. It's a faster song than I thought it'd be. Especially with how that opening was, the chorus feels kind of fast. Kool Aid Kids, smile until you are dismissed.
There's like a little bit of craziness to this song too, which I really dig. Solo. Down your cup so we don't drown. Another drink, another round. Down your cup so we don't drown. Another drink, another round. Down your cup so we don't drown. Another drink, another round. Down your cup so we don't drown. We drink. Oh, see, I'm telling, it's got a little crazy. Let's sign out. Okay, okay. So, how anyone... I don't know how people pause in the middle of videos. Well, at some point, I'll nail it, but this was so hard to pause through. Minus the fact that this definitely has like a tinge of craziness, which works because you need it for these lyrics. It's so good. It's like a little wild. I liked this part at like 224 where like how it was shot, because it like flickers through the members. Not something you're gonna notice in the live, but in the post it's like a cool detail. And their facial expressions, their facial expressions combined with the buildup and the like fast switching, it feels really good. Even though it's an afterthought, even though it's after the live performance, they know people are gonna look at this. So like they're adding a sort of editing element to the pacing, so when you're watching it from like our perspective now, it's enjoyable. Kool Aid Kids might be up there for me. I don't know, I gotta run some of these back. I do like this song a lot. I tend to like wilder songs, where you feel a little crazy. The lyrics and the whole message itself is crazy. So, yeah. Okay, so that's it for now. I think the next three songs we check out will... those are like the big hitters. I think a lot of people told me to check out Dust to Dust. We'll see. But yeah, that's it for me. Let me know what you guys thought of these songs. Comment section below. Till next time, I catch y'all.